Hello everyone, my name is Nidhi Haryani and I'm a fourth year PhD student at CPES. I'll be showing the edge bridge and phase neck design for two GAN devices in parallel. This is the design for high power, high density GAN based edge bridge. The left picture is the DC bus bar, which has two plugins, in which each plugin I plug in my phase neck module. Each phase neck module has four GAN devices, two of which are in parallel. We use GAN because GAN has lower conduction and lower switching losses, which enables us to go to higher switching frequency. I'll first talk about the gate driver design for a single device. We have an isolated gate driver which can support a DVDT of 200 volts per nanosecond, which is required in GAN, as GAN can go up to a DVDT of 60 volts per nanosecond too. The turn-on voltage for this GAN device is 6 volts, and the turn-off is for the single device case is 0 volts. That's why we need a regulator after the isolated power supply to supply the gate driver. This is the gate driver block diagram for the parallel devices case. The main difference in the parallel devices and the single device is that the parallel devices require a negative off voltage, as when we parallel devices, we have a higher Miller capacitor, and if we don't have a negative off voltage, it might lead to a false turn on of the device. Another very important thing for parallel devices is that we have split gate resistors for each device in parallel, because otherwise it might lead to circulating ringing between the two parallel devices, which might even lead to the breakage of the device. This is the phase neck design for my GAN edge bridge, which we'll see in the prototype. This is the double pass tester design, which I'll show in my setup. This is the double pass tester board that I was talking about in my presentation. Each phase neck has four devices, and on the tops of the board, we have two GAN devices in parallel. These two parallel devices are the high side devices, and then these are the two bottom devices on the board, which are the low side devices. And these are the decoupling capacitors, high voltage decoupling capacitors. These are as close to the devices as possible. And this is a plug-in module which goes into the DC bus bar. So my power loop starts from DC plus and then through both the devices, and then each shunt, which is in series with each device, and then it goes to the other side of the board, which makes my power loop as small as possible. This is the bottom side of my board, and this has all the gate driver components, the two gate drivers over here, and this is the gate driver for the high side devices, and this is the gate driver for the low side devices, and these are again some DC decoupling capacitors over here, and this is the plug-in which goes into the DC bus bar. We can see that the biggest part on my board is this isolated power supply. But this one has a very small isolation capacitance. That's why it is important to have this for high power, high frequency converters to suppress the common mode noise. This is the double pass test result for the 400 volts 80 amps turn off case. The pink one is the inductor current, that is 80 amps, so each device current is 40 amps. And the green one is the VDS waveform, which has a very small overshoot. And the blue and the yellow waveforms are the VGS waveforms, which also have very small ringing. This is the turn-on waveform for 400 volts 80 amps case. And this one has very small ringing, so since we have split gate resistors. Like I said in my poster, that in parallel devices, it's important to have split gate resistors for the two devices. Otherwise, we have very high ringing during turn-on, so that it actually breaks the device.
Thank you for watching the video, and hope to see you at the conference.